How do you explain the marrying or the integration of more of being more feminine or that what I, you know, the, not just what I call, but the divine feminine, like how do you marry that with a woman who has grown up in a very patriarchal, like we've all grown up in this very much patriarchal world order where the accolades, the success, the money, the construction companies, all the things, those are all celebrated. But the, you know, sitting, you know, meditating, I mean, maybe you can gamify it if you have like a muse headband or something, but like the present moment, and surrendering to the unknown is much harder to quantify for people. So in your words, in your experience, in your knowing, how does the feminine show up for you?
Yeah. So I think what's been, again, this is a bit of a laugh. I love my own like ridiculous sense of self and superiority sometimes in that masculine sense. That when I look back at myself, I recognize that the way that I achieved all this masculine kind of accolade and brilliance was actually entirely feminine all along. So the creator in me, the creative kind of person who has always loved the unknown, actually thrives best in the let's just witness it. Let's just allow it to unfold. Let's create the relationships that afford it the best opportunity for life. Has always been how I built everything, through partnerships, relationships, having vision, not relying on the algorithm that's telling me what to do next, but questioning it. The way that I feel into it is, it's just the balanced force. So the feminine to me can be just equally as vicious.
Yes.
Like if you look at the species,
it can be
every
profane.
Species.
Yes.
The female of the species is the most venomous, the most deadly. Yes. She's the hunter. And I guarantee you, like if it was my husband v me to feed our children, I would probably kill and maim in just such a much more vicious way than he ever would. So I think there is this duality that has been a little bit, no one likes to admit the viciousness. So I actually like to just apply it as the balanced force, because the feminine is such an active and important part of that. And the masculine can also hold steady. So it's the creator who understands balance. To me, that is kind of where I like to operate, but it's allowing the creator to have merit and not to hide her and not to say, well, because there isn't stats that support the knowing, because there is, you know, all of this intuitive sense of creation, it doesn't come with a rock we can stand on. It only comes with the proof we afford it by living into it.